So a question came up about what it means when you have a spot on your fingernail. And I was thinking that's sort of a old time question. I remember the days when doctors used to look at your tongue and your fingernails and sort of do examinations based on signs that they might find there. And I just wondered if that was still the case or if medicine has gone beyond that simple sort of hands-on kind of clinical sign. So here to answer that question is Dr. Robert Markison, and I'm really curious about what you're going to say, Dr. Markison.
Thanks always for having me. I'm not a dermatologist, but I do look at nails.
You do?
I don't do palm reading so much anymore, but I do look at nails. At any rate, nails tell a story. If you've got a dark spot, then that's something that you should see probably a dermatologist about, because some bad things can happen under the nails, including subungual, meaning below the nail plate, melanoma. And so that is something you need to look at. You can have benign dark streaks on a nail. But I think the conversation began earlier with little white spots. And so do you have white spots on all the nails or just one nail?
Just one nail.
All right. Well, that means probably something happened to that finger. The upper limb nail plate growth is about 3 to 6 months. So they tell a story. I probably won't get in close enough to be able to even show you my nails, but I had a mild case of COVID and I'm still alive. And that was about 6 months ago. And so I have tiny, tiny little white areas on all 10 nails, just telling me that, oh, something happened systemically. It was COVID. I feel great, felt great then, but it was just a mild case, fully vaccinated now, so on, so on. But the story is told by little spots across. If, for example, you had a traumatic injury to one finger, even if it's not at the nail growth area called germinal matrix, you could have a little spot or perhaps a little ridge, and then that grows out. And it's not fair to give it just one cycle of growth. It might be two cycles, so 6 to 12 months. But nails do tell a story. Certainly if they're brittle nails, we're changing in some significant way, you think about thyroid. The systemic causes of various changes can be iron deficiency, cirrhosis of the liver, heart failure, diabetes, zinc deficiency, psoriasis, eczema. I mean, there's an array of systemic things that can happen, self versus self, manifest by the nail appearance. But a single digit white spot, something happened if it's mid nail, 2, 3, 4 months ago.
And I think it's really heartening that some doctors still look at this kind of thing.
Well, sure, you have to love people, and in my case, you have to love the hand and try to take care of both situations.
So last question is, how many doctors do you think everybody's so focused on MRIs and technology that they're not looking at fingernails anymore? Or do you think that this is still something that doctors look at?
No,
I mean,
doctors,
aside from you.
Doctors don't look at it. Listen, in 4 years of medical curriculum and 200 plus American med schools, you might get 4 to 8 hours learning about the hand. So it's massively devalued in the context of, oh, the wonderful brain, the wonderful heart. Those other things matter, but they're common to worms. But we've got these wonderful little parts, our set of digits. So yes, I think it's a great idea, but let's go back to, 460 to 375 BC, the great Hippocrates. What could he look at? He looked at nails. He looked at everything, nutrition, holistic view, in view. And so we have to go back to that real sensory eye contact, physical contact exam. Telemedicine will never cut it for that.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is why we have Dr. Markison as our medical expert. Thank you so much for clearing this up and paying attention to things for these wonderful appendages that are unfortunately not valued enough and too few doctors really appreciate and study. So we are lucky to have you.
Little things matter.